This is Jackie Fogel, and I have a Bedlington here. Her name is First Class. Hats off to Willow Wind at Saratoga. She was the number one dog in the country a few years ago, shown by Kelly Miller. Her brother was also the number one dog in the country for 3 years. We are going to do a combined grooming video and talk a little bit about structure so that you can see how the grooming fits together with the structure and get to know the breed a little bit better. So, mostly it's grooming. We'll show you the techniques, and as I groom, I will be talking about the structure. What's correct, what isn't. There isn't much that's not correct on this dog. What you can do to enhance or improve. So, I'm going to start. Well, first of all, we did the 40 blade on the ears, the face, that line from the top of the ear, corner of the eye, corner of the eye, corner of the mouth. That's all done with the 40 blade. It comes down into a V shape about an inch above the sternum. And by the way, this should have a sternum. It's there. So that should start about an inch above that sternum. And it goes into a V shape to the back of the ear. The tail is also shaved. The bottom is completely shaved. And the top, about a third of the way down, tail starts back here. About a third of the way down, the hair stays on the tail and the rest is shaved with a 40 blade. So the next bit that we're going to talk about is what to do on the shoulders. One thing I like people to know right away is that this is a lean, racy breed. There should be no bulk, no coarseness. It's elegant, it's racy, it's a running dog, basically, so you don't want any coarseness at all. If you think sight hound, then lighten on their feet, and that sort of thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a 7 skip blade. It's a skip, not a 7F. And we're going to do a bib shape on the shoulders. And what we're doing, and you'll find that we do this a lot, is we reveal the dog that's underneath the hair. That's why it's important to use a blade on this part of the body. Because you would have a very hard time scissoring this close enough to reveal the elegant, narrow, slab-sided breed underneath all that hair. Okay, so that's quick. There is no elbow separation, so I'm not going to go down that far. Now, this part is key. From the withers, she's tightly knit withers, with a nice layback in shoulder and a return on layback. You want to go back about an inch and bring the mane in to the back about an inch behind the withers. So you float the top of the blade till you get to the shoulder blade and then you come in. And then you rotate and come in. Little note on this, only a well-constructed dog can have this done with its shoulders. If the dog has very wide shoulders or if it has curved shoulder blades, see how flat these shoulder blades are? If you see this dog from the front, Tabitha, you want to come over? You see how flat the shoulder blades are, how narrow the dog is? That's a well-built, well-constructed dog. For those of you who don't remember Saratoga, she finished her championship by winning Best in Show. So she's a pretty well put together dog, at least a lot of judges thought she was. So I want you to note how narrow she is in front, how flat those shoulder blades are. If she wasn't this narrow, if they weren't that flat, you would not be able to use a 7 blade because all you would do is reveal rounded shoulder blades and withers that are too far apart. When the grooming is done, I'll have Tabitha show you a shot from above so that you can see how actually narrow this dog is. And that, of course, it fits the standard when it says it should be a slab-sided breed, narrow slab-sided breed. And you can see when we remove the hair, you can see that forechest with no hint of ewe neck. Now, there are a lot of people who seem to think that the only way to get high head carriage is with a ewe neck, And I'm here to tell you that's not true, because we get high head carriage with most of our dogs. It's a well-built Bedlington will carry its head high without a U-neck. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to take off a little bit of hair back here. And I'm going to reveal. You'll hear me say that a lot. I'm going to reveal the angulation that's already there just by taking that hair really close with the clipper, and then we'll blend it with shears later. Okay, now we're ready for our scissoring. Say hi, Saratoga. I always start, I start with the rear and work forward, but I am always grooming the line that I see. So you're gonna see me jumping around a little bit, and that's because I see this line, and I see this line, and I see that line if I stand here. So you're gonna see me jumping around a little bit, because that's kind of efficient. If you cut the line you see, and you stand in one place, you see lines in a lot of different areas on the dog's body. So let's start with the top line. They should have a curve to the top line. There is a slight rise over the loin. So where do you find the loin? On a male dog, it's easy. It's in front of the penis. On a well-built dog that has a nice rib cage that extends all the way back here, that's the loin. So that's where you want the rise to be. Her rib cage goes all the way back here. She's got a moderate loin. Moderate is what you want on this breed. You don't want it long, you don't want it short. Moderate is good. So we're gonna start back here. We're gonna go straight up for the rise and then back down to where we made this divot here. So we'll start back here. And then we're gonna take off some of this excess hair. Saratoga hasn't had a show groom in quite some time. We're waiting for her to come into season. It's about time that she has puppies. So she's a perfect candidate for this right now because she's way overgrown. All right, now we're gonna reveal a little bit more of these slab-sided ribs. I'm gonna take off a lot of hair on the side. When we're done with the video, I'm guessing she won't have a really great finish. So if you're thinking that she's gonna look like a dog from a grooming contest, that's probably not gonna be what you're gonna see. But you are gonna see a dog that's groomed to reveal beautiful Bedlington structure. I wanna take the mane down, make it a small mane. I set my shears right down where that divot is. Remember we talked about an inch behind the withers? Take my shears right there. And look at what that does to the neck. It gives her a neck. She has a beautiful long neck. Anyway, so we're revealing her lovely long neck. A little bit more on the slab-sidedness. I'm gonna come back here and do this from a slightly different angle. The high point is last rib, right there. And then down to the withers. Angle your shears in so that you give them a waist. It's important that they have a waist. Remember, lean and racy. That's part of lean and racy. You should never have the hint of coarseness or heavy boned or hard on its feet. The standard talks about light spring at slower paces, very sight houndy. We don't have any chalk or any product on this coat, so you're going to see it sometimes be affected by the static. And we'll just have to live with that today. You want the chest to be at the elbows, and you want these elbows tucked in tight. Now, it's hard to see with all this hair, but there is no gap here. This dog's elbows are here. They're tucked in tight to her chest, and her chest comes all the way down to the elbow. So there is no such thing as a perfect dog. This bitch is no exception. If I were to change anything on her, I would want her legs to be a hair longer. Otherwise, her structure is pretty amazing. So what I'm going to do with grooming is I'm going to make the legs appear as long as possible. We're going to take this hair under here up as close to the chest as we can. And we're going to extend her leg up, so that gives the look of slightly longer legs without the elbow sticking out. Now this allows you to see, that's her elbow where my finger is, how tight it is, tucked in tight, beautiful flat shoulder blades, tucked in elbows, and no gap behind the elbows. So we want to pull all that hair up and scissor it off to reveal that lovely depth of chest. And we're going to make your eye carry this leg up a little higher. So that we make her legs look just a little bit longer. We're going to accentuate the tuck up. You want a definite, defined tuck up. And you want a well-angulated rear. If you read the standard on a Bedlington and on a Whippet, they read exactly the same. They use almost the same words. They describe the same rear. You want a well let down stifle, well angulated hock. So sometimes we call Bedlingtons whippets and drag because the standards are so similar. So we want to show off that angulation. Again, we're going to reveal that beautiful angulation. Long upper thigh, long second thigh. We also want a nice tight foot. Now it's hard to do this, and you'll see a lot of Bedlingtons with a lot of hair on their feet. I would take a good look at that foot and see how tight it was. We don't want splayed feet, although we do want a hare foot. That means they have long toes, but the foot should not be splayed. Nice short hock. With a back leg, a rear leg that appears longer than the front leg. And it sure does. The back leg looks like it goes up here. The front leg looks like it ends there. That's in the standard. You want to make sure that the dog from the rear does not ever appear bow-legged. There are a lot of people with nice Bedlingtons with pretty rears who make them look like this, bow-legged. They aren't doing their dog any favor by leaving that hair long like that. You're never following the actual structure of the dog. You're creating the look you want a person's eye to see. These lines should be narrow and parallel. They say we'll have Tabitha show you the dog from the top view when we get more of the hair taken off. I'll do a real quick groom on this side because then I want to get to the front legs. Again, a tight foot. I know the standard talks about corny pads, but quite frankly, we don't see those in this country a lot, but that doesn't mean the feet aren't important. So if you want to pick that foot up and take a look at it, see if it has corny pads, or see how tight the pads are, go right ahead. You certainly won't be insulting me, and you shouldn't be insulting any other Bedlington handler, because the standard does talk about corny pads being a fault. Again, on this one, we want to take these, want to reveal those nice flat shoulder blades. No curved shoulder blades here. That beautiful long neck that she has flowing smoothly into a top line with just the right amount of curve. Nice tuck up. We'll reveal that. Beautiful depth of chest. Tucked elbows. Yeah, we can cut that hair right up to the elbow. We don't have to leave a lot of hair here to cover up a big gap back here, because there isn't a big gap back there. We'll just reveal the beautiful dog that's there. Reveal the chest, the forechest. You can see the layback, the return on layback, tucked in elbows. Moderate loin, last rib again is here, moderate loin. The standard also reads, hair on the body should never be more than an inch long. So, a lot of us groomers like to accentuate the rise over the loin. If we do that, and most of us do, If the hair over the rise is an inch long, as you can see, that's about an inch and a quarter. If we do that, that's going to be the longest hair on the dog's body. Take that down a little bit to get it into the standard. That means everything else on the dog's body, all other hair on the dog's body, is going to be shorter than the hair right here. There is at least one judge, you'll see, very often she'll put her finger there, pull it out, that's about an inch. If someone has to build a top line because it isn't curvy enough, that hair will be significantly longer than an inch. Okay, we're gonna blend this beautiful long neck into the withers. It should come down to a point here, and this point should come out, and then the lines you should see at the top of this curve are narrow, showing off a narrow slab-sided rib cage. Can you see the top, Tabitha?
Sort of.
Okay. Let's come up to the front now and look at the front legs. And again, we're going really fast here. If we were doing an actual show trim, we would be taking a lot more time doing a lot more detail. I groom a leg that shows off the unique Bedlington front, which is a V-front. The V-front is defined as width here. You should be able to get three fingers in at the chest. And then as you slide your hand down, fingers have to come out. So it's wider here, and the feet are together. That's a correct Bedlington V-front. To accentuate that correct Bedlington V-front, I groom an asymmetrical leg that's straight on the inside and boot cut shaped on the outside, coming into a tight foot. See how that leg looks absolutely straight? But you want the elbows tucked in tight, like hers are, and then come out to a bit of a boot cut, and then back in to a well-formed tight foot. Always make sure you trim around the pads. You can't get a beautiful foot without trimming around the pads. It's a soft pastern. It is not a cylinder. So you want to show off the nice soft pastern. That's where, by the way, the spring comes from, is this rise over the loin, the soft pastern, and the beautiful narrow front.